What's up, guys? And the iPhone 13 leaks are back, and I'm happy to report that things are about to get exciting. The good guy Samsung is back again helping out its arch rival Apple. If you look at the camera on the iPhone 12 Pro series, it has added the things that were missing on last year's models, such as having night mode on all lenses, ability to shoot raw, etc. But it's still missing out on that pro hardcore camera upgrade that a pro 2020 flagship should have. So now it seems like Apple has finally set their eyes on the periscope camera system. According to ET News, Apple is currently looking for potential suppliers, and Samsung could actually help them out. Sources close to the matter are saying that Apple is looking to improve optical zoom on their upcoming iPhones, something that Apple did highlight in their iPhone 12 event in a misleading way, like who counts zoom from ultra-wide-angle lens. Anyways, they want to add a proper optical zoom setup on their iPhones, probably the iPhone 13 Pro Max model, and for that they need a proper periscope camera system. A folded periscope zoom camera system can provide high magnification without affecting the thickness of a smartphone, something Apple would really appreciate. Now, Samsung has done the periscope zoom setup twice. We had the Galaxy S20 Ultra, then came the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, and even the upcoming S21 Ultra will have the crazy camera zoom setup from Samsung ever. So understandably, Apple could take Samsung's help since there are not many companies out there offering the solution. Samsung Electromechanics is one of the companies that are working on this, and they also own some key patents related to folded camera, which led people to speculate that Apple could get Samsung's help. There's another brand named Core Photonics that can also be a potential supplier, but it is now owned by Samsung, as Samsung acquired that company back in 2019. Now, Apple is Samsung's biggest arch rival, but Samsung has changed their way of business. They have been profiting by giving out their chips and their cameras to brands like Xiaomi, Vivo. They've been helping out Apple with their OLED displays since the iPhone 10, and they have made a lot of money doing that. And now, with the involvement in iPhone's camera, this can be more profitable for Samsung than ever. As Apple sales are pretty good, it will be interesting to see if this indeed happens or not, as this will turn the competition to a whole new level between the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra and the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now, speaking of iPhone 13 series, Ming-Chi Kuo has come out with a brand new report. According to Kuo, there won't be any mass production delays with the iPhone 13 models like we have seen with the iPhone 12 series. One of the reasons why Samsung has claimed the top position in United States is because Apple was late to the show. Instead of the usual September launch, the iPhone 12 lineup came in September and November. But this won't happen next year, as iPhone 13 lineup will get introduced most likely in September of 2021. Now, speaking of big personalities in the Apple leak game, Mark Gurman is expecting Apple to bring back the in-screen Touch ID on its iPhone 13 lineup. Perhaps now may be the best time, because we're living in a very special situation. Face ID doesn't work when you're wearing a mask. Also, the state of in-display fingerprint scanners are getting to an absolute great level. According to the news, the Galaxy S21 series will be the first smartphones on the market to have the bigger in-display fingerprint scanner. Previously, we had to put our finger on just one area, but now the finger recognition area will be much bigger, making it more comfortable to use. Now, would the in-display Touch ID replace Face ID? I don't know, but should it replace Face ID? Absolutely. A full-screen bezel-less iPhone has been the dream of Apple users. Even a punch-hole camera setup will look really, really good. And of course, it's gonna make that whole life with mask a lot more easier. Now, last but not the least, we have some massive news on their upcoming processor. Apple's recent M1 chip has completely changed the game, and now they're about to further destroy Intel by offering what could be Apple's strongest processor ever. Enter Apple M2 chip with up to 32 performance cores coming with the iMac and MacBook Pro. According to Bloomberg, Apple is looking to bring the ultimate upgrade over the M1 chip. Not just that, Apple has big plans for the GPU as well. Future Apple Silicon chips could come with 16-core GPU all the way up to 128-core GPU for the highest-end machines. This reportedly could be several times faster than whatever Apple has used so far from Nvidia or AMD. So that's all with the latest Apple news. The iPhone 13's ultimate camera upgrade could come with the help of Apple's biggest rival, Samsung. A possible return of in-screen Touch ID. The future of Apple is looking really exciting. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. As always, I'll see you guys in the next one.